Hi, I'm Jade, and today we're opening my first ever diamond painting Deutschland. I am so excited about this painting, I can't even. Originally, I wanted to get Josephine Wall's Taurus from Diamond Art Club. However, they have not released it yet. I will probably get it still because, like, why not? When I saw Diamond and Washi get Josephine Wall's painting from Diamond Painting Deutschland, I was like, ooh, maybe that's something I should get. And then I was like, no, like, I don't know how expensive that is. And I messaged the company and I was like, hey, I'm thinking about buying this. And they didn't get back to me. It turns out I'm dumb. And I emailed them on my computer, which I guess connected to my iCloud email, which I didn't even know I had one. There's emails from Diamond Painting Deutschland, and I'm like, really? I'm over here being a dunce thinking that they're ignoring me. They gave me an invoice right away and shipped it out the next day, and I wasn't supposed to get this till Wednesday. It's Monday, Memorial Day, so I got this on Memorial Day. How cool is that? I was thinking that it was possibly, like, just hype, but after, you'll see. But like I said, I was influenced to buy from Diamond Painting Deutschland by Jadeikens and Washi. I'm not sure what her channel name is, but her name is Lisette and she's from France. I watched her video on diamond painting. And then there is, it's something like Schwindy Cindy or something. I'll link all of the people I'm talking about, but seeing them three get these, I was like, you know what? Josephine Wall from Deutschland looking pretty nice right now. And then I had gotten a refund from a previous experience I had. I will link that video above. So I was like, well, instead of being sad and sitting on money that I got refunded, I'm gonna use it wisely. So I bought a painting from Diamond Painting Deutschland, as well as something from Mary's Diamonds, because I can never stop buying them from them, apparently, because they got started customs. Anyway, that's not what this video is about. This video is about Diamond Painting Deutschland. So I already unboxed this and opened it, and I'm excited for you guys to see, like, what the painting looks like uncovered. But let me just show you the color sheet. It said it was 250 colors, which is already a lot. When I got it, it's 275. I think that's what it says. Yeah, 275 colors, so I'm like, I'm gonna be using these containers. So, pray for me? I like these containers, so I'm not complaining for that. Just the sheer amount that I'm going to need. Also, I have a weird thing. If somebody says a company includes stickers for their inventory, I immediately buy. I didn't see anything I really liked from Craftably. You know what I did? Bought stuff from Craftably because somebody did an unboxing and said, they have stickers! Well, I'm sold. You have stickers for the thing? That makes my kidding up experience easier. I'm gonna try it just to see if I like a company based purely on the fact that there's a sticker inventory sheet. That is, I would pay an extra 10 bucks for that. And I'm a cheap girl. I don't even pay for clothes. I did all this. I reupholstered this couch that we found in a field. I am cheap and I would pay $10 just for stickers. I'm gonna get down to the unboxing so you can see why I'm so hyped, and I'll see you again up here at the end of the video. But before you go see that, why don't you go ahead and sting that like up and subscribe button, become a member of my hive, join my colony, you know, have fun, be a honeybee, and I think that's it. Okay, on to the video. I today got my painting from Diamond Painting Deutschland, and it is so big, and my camera zoomed out, you can't even see it fully, so let's get into this. I got Josephine Wall's, this is Taurus, the zodiac Taurus, so yeah, I don't know what any of that says, but I know it's a square and I know that it's 200. Oh my God, it's 275 colors. Let's pop this baby open. Oh my God, I'm so nervous. You know, this justifies the price for me, like how everything is. Aw, they sent me candy. That's sweet. Here's a toolkit. I'll get into that. One bag of drills. Oh, there's all my stickers. Two bags of drills. yeah, that is it. So let's look through those before I pull the canvas out. Actually, let me lay the canvas out so it can relax a little. Now that my table's cleared, by the way, this table is never clear. So I did this just for this because I know it's double-sided adhesive, and I've never had it, but I've watched a lot of videos on how to properly store and use your double-sided adhesive canvases, and I'm so paranoid about messing it up, so that's why my table is completely clear, and this is going to be the only thing I'm working on while I'm at my house. All right, let's pull this baby out. Ooh. I'm guessing it goes like this. So I'm gonna roll it out and let it be its most authentic self. Oh, this is bigger than I thought. I have a diamond art club that is, I believe 100 something by something, and I thought this was gonna be smaller, but it looks like it's pretty close in size. Like it's slightly shorter this way. Also here, oh, they changed the way they did the layout. The schematic is this way. I'm gonna cut that off, by the way, probably in this video, because I'm just gonna cut it off. Maybe I'll make a belt out of it or something. Because if you don't watch my other content, I am a seamstress, so like, I can do stuff like that. I'm gonna fold this over for now, but I will be cutting it off. Just so y'all are prepared. It's actually flattening out pretty well, but we're gonna look at the drills and such while this completely relaxes, because I do not want to force any rivers on this baby at all. I'm so scared. I'm terrified. Let's look at the, ooh, it comes in a nice baggie. Nice baggie. So you get branded diamond painting. Hold on, let me zoom you in. Get branded diamond painting Deutschland tweezers, and I've seen from other people's unboxings that these are round. Mine got a little bent out of shape, but that's not too bad. A typical white boat. I think a 10 placer. I don't use the fat placers just because they don't work the way I want. Piece of wax, which I also don't use, but I'm happy that they give this to people. Ooh, but there is a skinny 4 placer. Like, you can usually tell because if they're white, they tend to be thinner, so I don't know if you'll be able to tell. But the 10 placer, see how much thicker that is? That's why this one's, people refer to these as the fat ones. But if they're completely white, usually they're the thin placers. Oh, and a pen that fell out. So that's it for that. You know, just a basic toolkit. So right over this, I will be putting the photo that this painting will become. It is Josephine Wall's Taurus, and you may be wondering, why'd you get Taurus? Because I'm a Taurus. I think it's pretty obvious. Also, my mom's a Taurus, so if I end up not wanting to keep the painting, it can go to my lovely mother. And I also got this because it was the Josephine Wall that had the most, green. So as you can see, all of these browns are in the people and the bull itself. Fun fact, I actually want to get a septum piercing. See, I think these will fit nicely into my small bags, or my I'll talk about it later. I'll show you what I'm going to kit up in. But anyways, I love all the greens, and these are all labeled with what they are. I do like that they put the weight, because it helps me guesstimate how many containers it's going to use, instead of guessing and then overfilling or underfilling, thinking I'll need two, but I really only needed one, and stuff like that. But what I'm gonna do is I'm going to arrange these by rainbow order, because I feel like that's gonna give me the easiest time. If you've watched Diamonds and Washi, she does it by the symbols, and that is genius, but my brain does not think in symbols, because to me, symbols are all, they are what they are. I'm not gonna group them into symbols, because that's just not how my brain works. My brain likes to see color, so it's like, oh, this area has a lot of green, let me look to the green. That square is green, okay, let me go to this section. That area is pink, I'm gonna go over here. You know what I mean? Hopefully that makes sense. So you do get 3 luscious bags, and as you can see, they're not very full because of how confetti heavy these paintings are. Look at all of those. I love it. I love it.
You know, and I am the type of person to really love confetti, and I'm nervous because the most amount of drill colors I've had is, I think, like 65, and this is 270. That's like five times, pretty much. Maybe a little less than five times, maybe a little more. I don't know. My brain does not do math. So these are stunning colors for me because as I... Ooh, there's a red... There's a rogue, like, clear crystal drill. I wonder where that came from. I always love seeing the little weird ones. I collect all of my trash. I collect all of my weird in-between drills. As you can see, I'm towards the end of this painting because, like, most of the containers are empty. But I keep my twins. So these are all drills that are stuck together. These are just ones that I spilled and didn't happen to put them back in the container before I realized where they were or where they came from. And then trash is just trash, but I keep them. I keep them, and I don't know why, but I must, and I must organize them, and it makes me happy. And I use my label maker to make little things. And I love that that has a little cone, and I wish I could have a little trash can, but also there's my rosary that my dog broke the other day. So that's what I do with my different types of drills. So let me put this away. Okay, I cannot find them right now, but essentially I will be using the containers that are double wides of these because you can get a lot of colors in these. And since these are so small, I think most of them will fit in one container. And I saw in other people's kit ups that they had stickers, and the stickers will fit on that perfectly. And also the stickers do have the colors, so I'll be able to see what I need, if that makes sense. And I just prefer this. This is what I use for nearly all of my kitting up. So I think since these are a small amount of colors, it'll work for these, because this painting is around the size of Diamond Art Club's old shoe house, which I'm working on right now. I'll put a photo up of my whip, my work in progress. That one takes up three of the double wide containers, so it would take up six of these, which I could just do that because I do have a lot of these actually. But I think these, since it's, that canvas is slightly bigger, I think all of these drills will fit in six of these small ones or three of these double ones, and it'll make it a lot more manageable. Actually, I think I will keep it in the six, that way I can shuffle through them as I need them. And the, oh, six would be perfect because it'd be like reds, oranges, yellow. Well, I mean, I don't think, actually, no, because there's gonna be like four of these with just greens. So let me peel the back of the paper to show you a little bit more of the painting. All right, I've seen people do this, but I'm still nervous as all heck. Oh, the greens and the yellows, okay. I know this is gonna sound weird since I've never had a double-sided adhesive canvas. The glue smells nutty. Like, it smells like, yes, I'm sniffing glue. I don't know, it smells like almonds almost, but mixed with like an in-between of almonds and peanuts. I don't know if that makes sense. Oh my God, I'm in love with this. I love cows. Oh my God. Oh my God, I love this so much. You know what? I'm gonna start from the bottom and go to the top. Oh no. No, I'm gonna do one side and then I'm gonna do the other because greens and yellows and browns are my favorite colors. Pinks. Oh, you can't even see what I'm talking about. Hold on. Let me zoom you out, beautiful people. Okay, that's as zoomed as out as we're gonna get. But this is the most important part, and I'll take you on my hand, like take you off of my tripod to show you the whole picture once I do this. But these colors are my favorite colors. I'm not a big fan of, there's pinks and purples over here, not a big fan of those, so I don't want that to be how I end off my painting. And then there's a lot of blues over here, which again, those are my least favorite colors. I know that's strange. I just don't, they're not a vibe for me. I don't vibe with them. They're not my not my jam. The seam along the double-sided adhesive looks pretty good. It doesn't look like it's missing any type of adhesive. Oh my God. Oh my God. Don't get me wrong, Josephine Wall, she does beautiful work, but I'm not a huge fan of her faces, like the detail in them. I'm kind of glad that the faces are not super like here. That way you can see. I'm glad the faces aren't super like defined. Like this isn't way bigger so that you can see them. I'm fine with them just looking like people from afar, but I did not like the face specifically she was making in the rendering, or not the rendering, the actual image. Love Josephine Wall. I'm just weird with how I like faces in my art. Off of the tripod. You're gonna be missing the last like 3 inches because, oh my God, how did I not realize there were butterflies in this? My mom also loves butterflies. Hold on, let me get to this side of my table.
How perfect is this? Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm like in a mood today. So like, sorry. but if you like my personality, hey, sting that like and subscribe button, become part of my hive, join my colony. But my favorite part is the bowl. I think it is beautiful. I love its little nose ring. I think I'm gonna replace the nose ring, specifically just that, with, and possibly the jewelry as well, with, let me show you. Oh my God. It's so pretty. I have some crystal drills that I got from Shimmering Canvases. And this is like gold. And I think that would look just spectacular in the nose ring and that, and possibly the eyes just to give it more of an ethereal effect. Maybe not. Maybe I'll decide not to. I don't know. I'm not sure. But let's see. See how the faces aren't super defined? I like that. I'm a fan of that. I'm gonna tuck my pinky in, so let's pretend that I do have a acrylic nail on it. But the bowl, that was the whole reason I wanted this. Even if I end up cutting the painting in half so I can frame that, I'd be happy, but I won't do that. I can't do that to her work. But look, I'm gonna go over this so you can see. I already know I gotta save the bowl for last so I actually get to doing it. I love this like sunset, like greens and yellows matches my nails. And the bowl, just my favorite friggin' part. Here it is on my table. Wow, I kind of wasn't expecting to like it as much as I did, because like the painting's fine, but there's something about diamond paintings and the fact that they're rendered in a specific way. I kind of like the dotty art look that it gives. So I'm gonna take you up so we can talk more about this, and then we'll see what we're gonna do. Quick before I go back to like overhead me, do you guys have any tips on like, can you drill an area and then roll that, or should you never roll it? I don't know how double-sided adhesive works, especially when it's with big canvases. So can you guys comment your advice down below so like I don't ruin this, because it was expensive and I really like the picture. So if you could do that for me in the comments below, thank you very much. Is this painting not perfection? I was not as excited, like seeing, as I said in that segment, I wasn't as excited for Josephine Wall's, like, I mean, I like it, but you know, I wasn't sure how I was gonna feel about it. But seeing it, I just spit my cheek. Seeing it unraveled, I was like, oh. I have a thing for greens and yellows. I mean, as you can tell. But, ooh, I'm excited. This is like, I might actually get this one framed. I don't even know where I put it. Also, it's like a, it's almost like not a rag, but like a, like, you know how quilters, they'll do like specific things to show that they have the skill. This shows you have the skill. If you can work with 275 colors and figure out all those symbols, baby, you're golden. You're golden. That's what I'm equating this to. So I feel like if I can accomplish it, I'm like, I've made it. Not that like nobody has to attempt this. You are like a valid diamond painter. Who cares? Diamond painting, do whatever you want to do. Whatever makes you happy. I just like challenging myself because I have issues. I mean, I do the same thing with sewing. I'm over here making a wedding dress just because, well, I know I can do it, so let me do it. But that's a me thing. That's not a you problem. That's a me problem. So I'm super excited to work on this. I am going to record myself kitting this up. I'm going to do it in rainbow order. So if you're curious to see that happen, stick around. I have an issue. Would you guys like to see videos twice a week or once a week is enough? For diamond painting specifically. I'm gonna try and sprinkle in my hair and sewing videos, but I have not been feeling sewing because my sewing area is a disaster. And my hair, I kind of figured it out, so there's not many things I need to try, but I will try them. So those I feel like I will sprinkle in, but how often would you like to see diamond painting videos? Should I do 2 times a week? Once a week enough? What do you guys want? Let me know in the comments down below. I'm gonna actually put this specific project in a playlist because I know I'm gonna be doing probably like quite a few videos on this because, well, one, to get my money. Hello? I'm recording. Oh. You look so cute, you old lady. Sorry, my grandma came in. Anyway, there's going to be several videos on this project, so let me know what you'd like to see from this specific project, because I know what, like, I like to see from other people. So I'm for sure doing the kitting up, because I find it fascinating, and, especially with so many colors, which, this color palette, oh my god, as you can see, I chose this outfit based on Miss Cat, darn you. Anyway, based on the fact that there's so many green and yellows in this. So I'm excited, I'm happy. This color palette really is what, like, ooh. I'm working on quite a few things that have a lot of black and like my lesser favorite colors because they're for other people. So, you know, other people have different color tastes. And I'm just like painting through it. I'm doing a section at a time and then putting it away for a couple days, so you know how it be. I'm real excited for this color palette. I feel like it's gonna get the juices flowing again. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you being here. Thank you so much. I love you guys. Hope you have a nice day. Let me know what you're working on, and I'll see you next time. Bye.